Well, good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station Update Hour. You're joining us here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the Orbit 2 team is currently on console monitoring all the respective systems on board this orbiting laboratory. That team today is being led by Flight Director Ron Spencer, there on the right, joining him at the CAPCOM position, serving as the communication link between teams here on the ground and the astronauts up in space, is NASA astronaut Clay Anderson. And those astronauts right now are the crew of Expedition 32. They're being led right now by Russian cosmonaut Gennady Padalka, currently on his fourth space flight. You can see him there in the middle. To the left is a fellow Russian cosmonaut Sergey Revin on his first flight on board the International Space Station. And on the right, NASA astronaut Joe Acaba, his second flight, previously flying on the shuttle mission STS-119. All three of the crew members earlier today participated in some onboard training, doing a Soyuz emergency egress drill, basically practicing getting into their Soyuz TMA-04M spacecraft in case of emergency, where the astronauts would need to quickly depart the International Space Station and return to Earth for things such as a rapid depress. You can see that Progress spacecraft off on the top of your screen. It's on the zenith-facing port of the Poisk module. So all the astronauts participating in that today and being walked through the procedures by teams here on the ground. Moving on, Commander Padalka also spent a few hours today doing a cabin fan assembly removal and replacement activity on the ATV-3, which is the unmanned cargo craft built by the European Space Agency, also currently docked to the International Space Station. Then in addition to that, he'll be doing some inspection and photography on some of the windows on the Russian service module, or the Zvezda, checking for any changes, any potential defects or marks, or any discoloration. Moving on, our second Russian cosmonaut, Sergey Revin, is stowing some items today inside of that 47 Progress vehicle, which will be undocking a little bit later this month, and then redocking, testing out a new core system for the automated docking that these unmanned cargo crafts use. That'll begin on July 22nd with that Progress 47 undock. It'll redock 2 days later, testing out that new system, and then finally undock on July 30th, and then burn up in the Earth's atmosphere upon reentry. As with all these events, we'll have live coverage beginning at 3 p.m. on Sunday, July 2nd of that undocking, and we'll also carry the redock operations 2 days later, and then that final undock on July 30th. So along with stowing items for all of these, he's also updating the station's inventory management system, which meticulously tracks every piece of hardware on board the station, so the astronauts and teams on the ground always know where to look. Then our third Expedition 32 crew member, Joe Acaba, the NASA astronaut, was doing some air sampling earlier today with the air quality monitor, checking the astronauts' breathing air. He'll also be doing some troubleshooting work with the ISAAC, which is the International Space Station Agricultural Camera, a laptop that is used to control that recently failed. So he'll be going through some steps along with specialists here on the ground to figure out what just went wrong. And then one other activity that Acaba will be doing coming up pretty soon, he'll be doing a ham radio contact with women in STEM, or science, technology, engineering, and math, high school aerospace scholars here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas.